I'm Bruce Rosenbaum, steampunk reimagineer of ModVic, and today we're at my home, gallery, and workshop, Steampunk Wonderland in Palmer, Massachusetts. Well, I was very excited about this project because I'm really connected to the sciences, to the medical community. You know, a lot of my artwork is based in STEM and STEAM. And I was approached by an interventionalist radiologist, and he was kind of doing his own version of a man cave, and he wanted something steampunk as part of what he did as a profession. With what he's able to do, or what the profession is able to do, is identify where a tumor or masses are exactly in the body, and then create kind of this nuclear bomb, really. It's like a smart bomb that is in forms of microbeads and can be injected in you and travel through your body, through your veins, directly into the tumor's mass, right in the center, and kind of kill just the tumor cells and not the healthy cells around it. And it reminds me of the story too, because in the 60s there was this the movie, and it's based on a science fiction book, Fantastic Voyage, where there's basically a crew of people and a ship that's miniaturized to go into a person's body and to kind of kill the disease. And so that kind of brought me to this place. Well, you know, I'd love to do kind of this representation of this X-ray Voyager ship that could be miniaturized and put into the body. So here what I was able to do is I found this piece here, the main body piece, is an X-ray tube from, I think it's probably from the 40s or the 50s. And so that becomes the body of my spaceship. And half these things, I don't even know what they did. I just know that they're used in science and experiments. Also included is a boiler tank stand. These are legs to something. This is another X-ray tube. This is actually an optical stand for an ophthalmometer, and some brass balls that would go on a bedpost. And these actually, I found these, they kind of look like the engines of the spaceship. These are actually bomb detonators, like at the cone of the bomb, and once the bomb would hit, this would send the signal. So I had all this kind of interesting stuff going on. I love using the Edison bulbs kind of to light up the sculpture and to give it some life. Here, I've been using a lot of glass eyes and glass marbles. So again, kind of looking into the future. And then this is a car emblem that has wings to denote flight. And this little foot pattern is actually a cobbler's pattern to make or to repair shoes. So kind of all of this came together in a way again, give this sense of taking old parts and pieces and creating something new, exciting for the future. And this red kind of sphere in the center is a stone. It's red. And it kind of reminded me of the planet Mars, and you know, now we're there's a lot of movement and excitement in Mars exploration. So I thought that would be appropriate for the piece.